Hello, B here, and welcome back to Biology. Did you know that your ears never stop growing, or that only 2% of humans have green eyes? Have you ever tried to breathe and swallow at the same time? Go ahead, try. I'll wait. It's impossible! The human body is a magnificent, beautiful, and complex biological structure. After spending our previous unit focusing on animals, we are going to go further in this unit. We are going to spend this unit learning all about the human body. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to understand how the body uses homeostasis and feedback loops to achieve equilibrium. Define and identify the four types of cells in the human body and how they organize to form tissues, organs, and organ systems. The human body is a complex but very organized and efficient machine. Looking at the hierarchy, cells are the building blocks of the body. Together, cells form tissues. Tissues form organs, and organs come together to form organ systems. Before we get into the body systems, starting in our next lesson, let's spend a little time talking about the human body at the cellular level. There are four main types of cells: muscular, epithelial, connective, and nerve cells. Muscular cells are also known as myocytes. You will see this prefix myo a lot in our lesson on the muscular system because it is used in most words relating to muscles. These cells make your body move by contracting. They also have a lot of mitochondria, which provide cells with energy so that they can produce a lot of ATP and provide the body with energy. Epithelial cells are your skin cells. These cells line all the internal and external surfaces of your body. They are tightly packed and form sheets or layers. These layers help to protect the various tissues and structures in your body. Connective cells form connective tissues. Makes sense, right? These cells and tissues provide support as well as connect and bind structures together. You can find these cells in bones, cartilage, tendons, fat, and blood. They are the most abundant and diverse types of cells in the body. Our final type of cell is the nerve cell, or neurons. These cells receive and transmit electrical messages within the body. They have a very unique structure that we will study in more detail in our nervous system lesson. Wow, this room is freezing. I wish the heat would turn on. Oh, phew, okay, it just turned on. Don't worry, it'll warm up in here quickly. And if it gets too warm, the heat will turn off and the air conditioning will turn on to cool the room down. Central heat and air conditioning in buildings is the perfect example of homeostasis and feedback loops. Homeostasis is the process of keeping the body in balance, regardless of external conditions or internal changes. This is kind of like how the heat keeps the house warm, even when it is freezing outside. The main processes that human bodies need to keep in balance are blood pressure, heart rate, blood sugar levels, and body temperature. Can you think of what a normal body temperature should be? 98.6 degrees. When any of these functions are not balanced, it can cause illness and have negative effects on your body. How does your body achieve this balance? As you can imagine, your internal and external environment is always changing. Human bodies use a process called a feedback loop to keep everything in check. The most common feedback loop is a negative feedback loop. In negative feedback loops, your body inhibits changes or processes so that the body can return to or maintain homeostasis. This happens after every meal. When you eat, especially something high in sugar, you end up with extra sugar in your blood. In response to this, your pancreas releases insulin, which is a hormone that works to lower your blood sugar. Another example of a negative feedback loop is sweating. When your body temperature rises, like during a workout, your sweat glands activate and release sweat in an attempt to cool your body down. Occasionally, your body will use a mechanism called a positive feedback loop to help maintain homeostasis. However, this is rare. Positive feedback loops are when a process is increased in response to a stimulus. An example of this process is blood clotting. When you have a cut, platelets in your blood release chemicals to attract more platelets, which help promote blood clotting. As we went through the lesson today, we started our exploration of the human body. We learned about the cells and tissues that make up the organs of our body. We also learned how the human body stays balanced. Throughout this unit, we will go into detail about each of the systems in the body and learn how they work together. But first, in our next lesson, we are going to have an introduction to all of the body systems. Until next time, remember that biology isn't just science, it's the way of life. Hey, hey. See you next time.